Understood me. So I have prepared an usual presentation. The full text of my lecture is reproduced on this presentation. This text is very large, and time for me for my lecture is not so much. I hope it will possible to read this lecture on the site of our university. Today our work is very difficult for me, and so I think for you also. My colleagues will help me in the difficult situations. My lecture is devoted to Galperin's theory and his method. Many times, very famous Russian psychologist Daniil Borisovich Ilkonin spoke, Galperin is the cleverest psychologist in Soviet Union. And you can be convinced of it when you will read and try to understand his articles and his books. I will continue my presentation. Galperin was born in 1902, and he died in 1988. Who is he? He is a teacher. This is our group in Moscow, University. This is, you can see me. Just a moment.
Can you see the Liudmila there on the picture?
Yes, yes.
Where is Liudmila there?
Where is me? In the center of this group. Yes.
Oh, what beautiful. Now changes, look.
And Galperin is very famous scientist, and many, you know these people, very famous foreign psychologists visited him in Moscow. The first photo, Kyosha Amana, and on the second photo, Laszlo Gary. What did he do in psychology? In his theory are presented new understanding of subject of psychology. In his theory presented the objective characteristic of mental life. In his theory are presented objective necessity of psychic, psyche, its vital value. This book, ach ты, Боже мой, just a moment, why not? I don't understand why. This book is the first book of Peter Galperin. The essence of this book consists in proving that orientation activity is a subject of psychology. In his theory is shown possibility of studying mental processes on the basis of stage-by-stage systematic formation. This book was published during when Peter Yakovlevich was alive. In his theory are analyzed the evolution of animal psyche. In his theory analyzed results of anthropogenesis and their value for formation of mentality of the human being. In his theory analyzed the primitive thinking and the qualitative difference between animal and human mentality. This book was published after death Galperin's death, when Galperin was 100 years. So he could not correct this text. In this theory, the concepts of the biological, organic, and social and human being mentality are differentiated. In his theory, the mental process are considered from the point of view of their vital sense. In his theory, your understanding of the research method of investigation, mental processes, is entered. This book about Galperin, this book was written very famous Holland psychologist Jacques Heinen. What did he do in psychology? He studied psychological process from point of view of their origin and development. He constructed the method and the theory step by step formation of the mental actions and concepts. The idea of forming experiment as method of psychology belongs to Vygotsky. The method applied by us can be named by experimentally genetic in sense that it is atypical causes and creates genetic process of mental development, wrote Vygotsky. Galperin improved this method in details and used it in various experimental settings. This book was published also after Galperin's death. What I can say about his method? According to Galperin, every subject action includes two parts, orientation and execution. The orientation of action serves as the psychological mechanism of any action. The execution depends on the orientation. The orientation may be either full or not. If we can find condition for construction of sufficient full orientational basis of action, the pupil will solve the task without mistakes from the very beginning and every time later. However, it is not so easy to find it. It requires a true deep investigation. Today I will try to tell you about three types of investigation, but I think I will have no such enough time for it. I will try. Three types of investigation. The first type of investigation, the form of concept which have complete characteristics. So this is some scientific, these are some scientific concepts that are studied at school, and the concept of conservation, Piaget tasks, etc. The second type of investigation, the investigation of productivity of thinking during open task solving, Guilford and Torrance. The third type of investigation, the concept formation, which has uncertain characteristics. This idea I found in Gardner article. The first type of investigation, the formation of concept which have complete characteristics. This is some scientific concepts that are studied at school. And the second example, the notion of conservation, Piaget tasks. the first investigation, formation of system of concept, pressure of solid bodies with application to the decision of tasks. Aim of this investigation, to form the ability to solve the tasks without errors from the first and each time further in children with learning difficulties. I will speak about this investigation very shortly because this investigation was published and was translated into German. But it is very necessary to tell about it. You can see physical task. You can. I will not read myself. You can read. You can see inclined lines divided the problem text into semantic parts. To solve the task, it is necessary to present a problem situation in drawing. We can see very good drawing on this picture, this slide. When the pupil represents problem situation by drawing it, he does not draw errors. But if the problem has to be solved without the image, the pupil came back to errors again. But we would like to teach pupil to solve these tasks without errors. And it is necessary to do it. You can see. Here you can see tasks on the heavy machine tool have put a detailed brusok. What he was pressing on the floor, if this detail on the machine tool to put on the edge will change. You can see. Before passing to the problem situation in mind, it is necessary to pick up from problem situation presented by means of drawing its essential features. Before passing to the problem solution in the mind, it is necessary to pick out from a problem situation presented by means of drawing, it is essential features. You can see. Tasks, and here we can see the operative scheme of thinking. This is absolutely necessary for transfer solving transfer from transfer in mental plan of activity during solve these tasks. Just a moment. Another task, and you can see how pupil can do operative scheme of thinking. We can see another task. You can read, but this is not so easy for pupil. And it is necessary to find operative scheme of thinking, and then pupil can solve this task without errors. The new find of this investigation is the concept of operative scheme of thinking. I think about, I said about it because in this book, this is very important book, and I think this book will translate into foreign languages, but in this book exist many mistakes. It is impossible to understand what is operative scheme. The operative scheme fixed the general essential moment of a situation corresponding to the formula. It represents the object of the analysis in the transformed form. It pulls together points of support. It unites forces of pressure. All components of a problem are completely materialized and clearly selected in the scheme. The scheme is the general for all tasks related to the given system of concept. This is very important moment. Now we will analyze the second investigation. The first type of investigation, the formation of concepts which have complete characteristics. This is the notion of conservation, and we will compare Piaget point of view and Galperin point of view. We can see this, their photos. At first, we will consider some theoretical position. According to Piaget and Galperin, the subject's action is a basis of any mental process. But the interpretation of the action, its structure, function, and genesis is different. In Piaget theory, thinking is a system of mental operations. Operation is an action that has been transposed to the intellectual level, been schemed, reversible, and coordinated with others to form integrated system. Piaget defines the action in terms of the level, internal, external, mobility, irreversible, reversible, degree of completion. It may be executed symbolically, and or developed, realized through real objects. Piaget does not analyze either psychological mechanism of action or its psychological structure, but merely emphasizes its physical and logical aspects. Piaget treats the subject action globally without distinguishing between psychological and concrete content. Piaget does not see any possible interpretation of the development of action other than its conformity to formal logical structures. Approach of Galperin. With his point of view, in each concrete action of subject, Galperin distinguishes two basic components, orientation and execution. I repeat, the subject's action is characterized by a complex interaction of orientation and execution. The orientation is the psychological mechanism of action, and its content determines the success and general quality of action. The success of action and quality of the mental process formed on its basis depend on the orientation completeness. The success of action and quality of the mental process formed on its basis depends on the orientation completeness. The orientation is a complex phenomenon which includes in it the follows: the image of action situation, the image of the initial subject action, the image of the final result, the image of the action itself, and its key points, the quality of the means or tools to fulfill the action, and at last, operative scheme of thinking. This is very important part of full orientation basis of action. Now I will speak about experimental study. This experimental, the transition from the pre-scientific thought to the first truly scientific thought of the child. According to Piaget, for him, principle of conservation is the psychological criterion of transition to new cognitive stage, the stage of the concrete operations. According to Galperin, principle of conservation is the necessary condition for the child to form scientific ideas. You know, I think, Piaget phenomena and this phenomena about the liquid conservation. I know you have such bottle and you can use it in your experiment. It is very simple. You can see the task, transfer, and answer of this mistake of this girl. He make mistake in this task. Goal of our investigation, we want to learn children to solve task of Piaget without any mistakes. What we should do? In accordance of Galperin's theory, we should orientate child, create orientation basis of their action. This means that we should give him a psychological tool. For the Piagetian exercises, this tool is measure and measurement. Scholars of many countries have tried to develop the notion of quantitative invariance conservation in the preschool children. The method of development of mental action developed by Galperin enable us to formulate a new hypothesis on the characteristics of this transition. We constructed our experiments in accordance with Galperin's method of the systematic formation of mental action and concepts. The first attempts to introduce measurement in Piagetian exercise ended in failure. The child succeeded in making the measurement but failed in final decision because of influence of visual image.